Okay, good morning. It's 10:46 a.m. I've been up about an hour and not quite an hour and a half, about an hour. Had my coffee. Dogs have been out watching The Price is Right. I'm going to hop in the shower in a little bit, wash my hair really fast because it needs it. I'm going to get dressed and I'm going to go downtown because I need to pick up some prescriptions. Now, normally with this being a Wednesday, normally I would go see my friend Melissa at Big Jim's, hang out with her, have dinner. Today I'm not going to do that because I actually have a chance to go off-roading with the Jeep group. So I'm going off-roading this evening. We're meeting at 4 o'clock and it's actually closer to my house than it is the city. So we're going to do that today. So that should be a lot of fun. It is hot. It's very windy and it's like a hazy overcast. It's sunny, but it's a hazy overcast day, and stuff. The rest of this week, Thursday and Friday, I really don't have much going on this week. Thursday, probably nothing. Friday, I'm not sure if I'm going to go grocery shopping or if I'm going to do that Saturday. I do have an event on Saturday in Tinley Park from 9 to 12 with the Jeep group, and I'm going to go for that. And I may even take Bob with if he wants to go with that, because that's just a meet and greet type day, and that should be fun. Saturday is the Cliffs, and right now, I think a lot of people are on the fence on whether or not they're going to go to the Cliffs on Sunday. Just because the forecast has a lot of rain in it, a lot of us newbies, myself included, have stock Jeeps. And you might ask what a stock Jeep is. Well, a stock Jeep is a Jeep that has absolutely nothing done to it. Yes, my Jeep does have things done to it that I've done. I've put in the halo lights and the tail lights. But when you're talking stock, you're talking about a lift system, shocks, bigger tires, all-terrain tires, mud tires, that sort of stuff. I haven't done any of that yet. And the one reason I haven't done that is Bob has less than a month left of school, which means that this summer his paychecks, he'll still get paid in the summer because he gets a retirement check, but he won't get his he won't get his paychecks every 2 weeks. We'll only have a paycheck at the beginning of the month of his and mine. So that's got to carry me through 3 months of July, August, and September. And then he'll get paid when he goes back to work. And lifts for the Jeep can be anywhere from $140 to they can run into the thousands, depending on how lifted you do it. Labor and all of that. Not to mention, if I go up to a 35-inch tire, that also means I'm going to need a bigger rim. And rims and tires run about $25,000 to $3,000 just for that, easily. And they can actually go more than that. They could go into the $4,000 or $5,000 range. So I'm not doing that right now. I'm not lifting the car. So I'm doing simple things just to get ready for the Silver Lakes in 2 weeks. And speaking of Silver Lakes, I'm leaving 2 weeks from Friday. And I will continue to update and brief you guys and remind you guys that while I'm at Silver Lakes on the 2nd of June through the 4th, you're not going to have a daily vlog. Just because I'm going to be busy camping. And the simple fact is the cell phone service is very spotty at best in Michigan. So when I get back on the 4th, I will do one big, long vlog to make up for the 2 days that are going to be missed. Actually, you're going to miss three days because what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a partial Thursday vlog and I'm going to post it on Thursday. So you may get two vlogs on Thursday. And that would be on the 1st. But I'm getting ahead of myself because that's still over 2 weeks away. So anyway, let's get this day started. I am editing the vlog that you're going to see on Wednesday. It should be up probably in about an hour. Okay, good afternoon. It's 12:08 p.m. and I am headed into the city. It got really cloudy and it is incredibly windy. It's currently 83 degrees, so it is warm today. But anyway, I need to actually go into the city to get some prescriptions, and I'm looking at my face of where I missed shaving, but I digress. So what we're going to do is we're going right into the city. And then, normally I would go, like I said, I would go see Melissa, but, this afternoon I have a chance to go off-roading, with some of the Windy City Jeep Force, group. And it's not that far from where I live. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get what I need done in the city, and then I'm going to head back, towards home. And then probably, depending on what time I get back to Homewood, will determine what time I go off-roading. We're meeting up at 4 o'clock, so I'll get there probably at about 3:45, 3:50, just so I'm not late. It should be fun. The forecast is calling for showers and thunderstorms this afternoon, but they said spotty. It just depends if it holds together or not. And we'll see about that. Hopefully it doesn't get that bad, because I am running a stock, like I said earlier in the video. So I don't want to get caught in the mud, because I don't have a way of... I do have my tow lines, though, in case I do get stuck. So somebody with the winch or another Jeep could pull me out. So I'm not worried about that. The Cliffs, Sunday. So far... people are interested in going, and some people have bailed on the Cliffs. I'm still up on the fence. I would like to go just to see what the Cliffs are like. But I'm not sure about, whether or not I want to actually go off-roading, because that's actually 1 week before the Silver Lake, event. And, you know, my Jeep is brand new, so we'll see how that goes. I am going to do a trip to the Badlands with the group, hopefully this summer. And you, from what I've seen the group does, is it does almost either weekly or bi-weekly trips to the Badlands. And the Badlands is about 2.5 hours from me. It's in downstate Indiana. But it hugs the Illinois state lines, so it's not all that far from me, because I'm already almost on the Indiana border with Illinois. So anyway, we're going to do that. Should be a lot of fun today. Gas-wise, I have a full tank of gas, but I may top it off when I get back, depending on, again, what time I do this. The rest of the week, like I said, is going to be quiet. I am not planning on going back downtown now until next Wednesday. And next Wednesday is actually going to be a special day, because my friend Michael, who just bought a condo in Chicago, is actually moving into his condo. So I figured I'd go help him celebrate his new condo with him, if he's still hosting that, and I'll find out probably next week about that. A lot of stuff is going on at the end of this month, beginning of next month, and next month, because next month, for those of you that know my situation, I'm married to Robert Anderson, and I have been with him for 18 years now. But the month of June is Pride Month for the LGBTQ group. So the Pride Parade is at the end of the month, and then they've got festivities
the week before and stuff like that. So that should be a lot of fun, and it's a good time with all of us. And Bob and I are probably going to go to the Pride Parade. I think this year it's the 25th, but I'd have to look on my calendar. It's the last Sunday of June. So I always go that. We also have a march. And just yesterday or last night, I noticed that Chicago did decide to join for the 11th. And normally I would definitely go for that, but I'm thinking that Frankfurt might be better because that's closer to me than the city, but I'm going to see what some of my friends do, if they want to participate in it or not. So we'll find out. That being said, let's go have a good time in the city. Okay, it's 1:35 and I am actually on my way home. I'm on Stony Island at 71st Street. I have our prescriptions. I'm gonna run back home, drop off the prescriptions, fill my Jeep up with gas. I need to pick up some milk for Bob. And then I'll meet the group at around 4 o'clock. I'll probably leave my house around 3:15 just to get up there in enough time, because it's not all that far from where I live, so that's pretty cool. Should be fun. I will be vlogging off-roading, but I may not be on camera. I may let the camera face forward so you guys can see what off-roading is all about. So stay tuned. Okay, it is 3:18 p.m. And I am headed over to go off-roading with the Jeep group. As many of you know, I joined a Jeep club on Facebook, and it is a great group of people that are very knowledgeable, extremely friendly, and plan like these really, really fun activity, meet and greets, off-roading events, and social events. So, it makes me really happy that I'm now involved in something. Although many of you watching my videos know I go into the city quite often to hang out with friends in the city, but this gives me an opportunity to do things that I would normally not have tried to do. So, that being said, the person I'm meeting up is actually running late. She's about an hour late. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to kill a little bit of time in Homewood. And then I'm going to head down there, probably closer to 15, 20 minutes from now. Because it'll take me about 25 minutes to get there, which is not too bad. So it should be fun. It is still incredibly windy and it is very warm. It's very humid. It's 87 degrees. It's also very cloudy. We're supposed to get a bigger chance of storms tonight. So we'll see if that holds true. And then tomorrow it's supposed to cool down into the upper 80s. And then Friday it's supposed to be just downright cold, only in the 50s. And then Saturday it gets back into the 70s. So, let's go have some fun off-roading. Okay, I'm getting ready to go off-roading. I've got two Jeeps in front of me and two behind me. So, we'll see how this goes. I'm going to flip the camera around so you can actually see what's going on. Okay, we're going off-roading, so I'm following the other two Jeeps and seeing how this goes. And so far, so good. A little dusty, but nothing the Jeep so far can't handle. so we're now off-roading. This is kind of cool. We are definitely off-roading. This is pretty cool. Bunch of us jeepers are doing this. This is like really cool to be four-wheeling. This is actually kind of fun. Alright, what are we doing? Wait, where'd she go? My God. are you? I may not come off the mountain. And that was an amazing night of off-roading. It was a lot of fun. I did some stuff that I would never have thought to do. I could see myself going off-roading. It was a little bit scary because I'm afraid of heights, especially going down one side of the hill. Was really steep, but I had another girl just show us. Happen and she actually took it down beside so I could watch what was going on, and I was like, oh my god, I was like gulping. But yeah, I think a couple more times and I'll get over my fear and it'll be amazing. I know I said I was not going to go into the city. Well, I decided I changed my mind because it's 7 o'clock and Melissa gets off in 3 hours, but I'll get there long before she gets off of work. So, I'm gonna go have a couple of drinks, grab a bite to eat, and then I'll be going home. So, I may include that. The vlog is already pretty long, and I know there were a couple of spots where I didn't, vlog, it, but I think I got some good captures of me doing it and stuff. So, hopefully you'll enjoy it. Or you enjoyed it, because it'll be included in the clip before this. Anyway, I'm going to close out the vlog for tonight. Thank you so much for tuning in. Tune in tomorrow for another fun-filled vlog. Oh, there is a PS. And I just, while I was off-roading, I got a notification that the Cliffs is off for Sunday. So I'm not going to be going off-roading Sunday, which is probably a good thing because it gives my Jeep a chance to get washed, cleaned up, stuff like that. And it'll get me ready for going to Silver Springs, or Silver Lakes, not Springs, Silver Lakes in the following weekend. So I am doing the topless event Saturday, but now Sunday I'm not going to the Cliffs. So the Cliffs was officially called off.